So guys, congratulations on this new record. It's just about to come out of Divided Kingdom. Now, it took a little bit longer to get this album out compared to with the last record. What was different this time around that it took a bit more preparation?
Well, there's lots of things happened in the meantime, really. To be honest, a lot of it, we were just gigging, like, really hard. Lack of funds to get in and record things. And we kind of started and kind of it changed our mind a few times, started demoing things.
Yeah, we went through a bunch of different demoing processes many different studios, and, yeah,
we went and played with another band for a bit. Alan did some solo stuff for a bit.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's kind of taken a while to get it together. But in that, I think we learned, like, a hell of a lot about, you know, what we actually wanted to say and, you know, what kind of sound and, you know, what kind of thing we really wanted to make, wasn't it? You know, like, we were very happy with our last record, and to progress from that has taken a while. It's a difficult second record, I guess, as a band, really. I've done several now, but for us guys, it was kind of, this was like the difficult second record, wasn't it?
Yeah, I mean, it did feel, because we were so happy with Saltwater, as John said, it felt like we really had to dig deep to try and hopefully make something better, and it was quite a big task in our heads to begin with, and then getting in, I think that the time stretch of it all, and the fact that we went through so many different demoing processes, really kind of solidified the stuff.
And band members,
like, it really solidified the stuff that we thought was strong.
Yeah.
And it kind of, it did give us a lot of time to refine it, really. And I felt that there wasn't really that much of a time pressure to start with. Like, we weren't saying we're going to make an album by this point. It was like it all kind of came together fairly naturally until we got the bones of it, and then it's like, right, we're running with this, let's go.
Yeah, I mean, we did the majority of the work in a very short space of time last summer, really. In here, in like the studio, in that sound studio, and we got this place set up, then that kind of gave us the opportunity to really go for it and to kind of build the kind of sound that we wanted and to learn what we wanted and the sort of capabilities of this place and to really go to town on, you know, on really working with like multiple amplifiers at the same time.
Even microphones and spacing.
Yeah, just really messing around to sort of come up with something great. And also, kind of the sort of political and social situation within the UK and, well, you know, probably the rest of the world as well, to be perfectly honest. That solidified what we were trying to say and what the album was about. We recorded a bunch more songs than we actually ended up putting on the album. The actual decision for what we used at the end came quite late on in the day, regarding sort of you know, our feelings about the sort of.
Well, it does seem that way. I mean, that feels like that's the real progression from the previous record, because you've always got this real high energy, there's a great tones throughout the record, but in terms of the writing, it feels like it's a little bit more specific to, you know, it's not a concept record, but, you know, it's almost a little bit in that vein. Was there concern over being so on the nose about what you were talking about?
Absolutely not. I mean, as a songwriter, you know, as a writer, and as an artist, your kind of duty is to sort of comment upon the times in which you live, you know. That's really your purpose, and it's like a horrible gift, I guess. You know, it certainly sort of solidified what it is that we were trying to say and how vehemently we were saying that. I mean, it would be better actually if it didn't have to. I mean, there's loads of different ways of looking at that. We wouldn't have come out with a record like we have that we're very pleased with and like very much is like of our time, I guess. But don't really necessarily want to have to be talking about this, the content that we are, really, and, you know, how screwed up the world is and politics is and, you know, society is. So, yeah, it decided that for us, really. I mean, what else could we say? You know, what else is there really to talk about at this point in time? I'm not sure.
Yeah. And it is interesting that, you know, you're clearly British and there's a British element to what you're saying on the record, but it is something that translates throughout the world, isn't it?
Well, yeah, I mean, it does. I mean, in terms of its message, you know, I think that crosses the world over. I mean, you know, one of the opportunities we get is to travel a lot and to meet a lot of people from a lot of different places and to talk about, you know, lots of different things and how it affects people in different places. And really, you know, it's kind of the same the world over. Wherever you go, you get into this conversation about the situation, the social and political, financial situation of many people, and disparity and like disharmony within the world. It doesn't really matter where you are. You know, we went to the jungles of Panama last year and met with people from all over the place there, and all the touring we do, and we have the same conversation everywhere. So it was kind of like, well, here we are, you know, this is what we have to talk about. And the record and the music got a lot heavier this time, I think, as well, and
yeah,
a lot more direct. It, kind of because of my housemate who's been really hammering us with Motorhead and Sabbath and various other things for like the last year that he's moved
in. You can hear this huge heavy element in there, and something that is, it's, you know, obviously the albums sound fantastic and this one is another one that's great, but hearing you guys live is a whole separate thing. You know, it might as well be, you know, night and day, two completely different things, because you go to and then sort of next level with the live thing. Do you ever find that when you take these songs out on the road and you perform them, that even though you've recorded them and you've got a version you're happy with, they evolve into something else, and then all of a sudden you wish it was that version that you'd recorded as opposed to the one that's on the album?
I don't think so, because that was that moment in time, and that's how we were feeling at that moment, and that's the raw emotion of what it is.
That's all the record recording is, isn't it?
Exactly.
It's just a snapshot of that moment in time.
The progression of the tunes, it happens so naturally as well. I almost forget if they have changed from, like, slightly from that recorded version.
There's a bunch of versions of songs that we play that are dramatically different from the recorded versions of them.
Yeah.
I mean, we've re-recorded Hungry Blues this time, which started off as an acoustic track.
Yeah.
And now it's like, I think the actual record of it was something like 10 or 11 minutes that we ended up with. We've edited it some and done some other versions of it, but a really expanded, heavy electric version of something that was quite a chilled out tune. Yeah. Coming Home, we play entirely differently now. It kind of sounds a bit more like The Doors than it. It started off as a very Hendrix-y kind of tune, and yeah, I mean, it happens all the time. It's exciting.
Yeah.
I think it's a true representation of how you're feeling at that moment, and that's the way that music should be. And you can't really have it any other way, because if you're playing the same thing, the same every night, in my opinion, you might as well just stick on a CD, because there's none of that raw emotion that you get from utter freedom.
Being the seat of your pants knowing where the hell is you actually are. Yes. You know, you know you're going to get to some point at some time, but you're just totally free at that moment.
And obviously with you guys, you know, you've got, you know, we've had, you know, quite a long history of playing together. You know, you said there, you've kind of hinted at some other people have been involved in it that didn't work out. How difficult was it adding extra members to the band? Why does it work with some and not with others?
Well, there's a million answers to that question. There really are.
I think a lot of it really is, we're away so much of the time, it takes a very like-minded individual to be prepared to kind of almost give up their life for it, because you are away so much of the time, and you miss so many important things, and it's from like friends and family that you just can't make, because you're the other side of the world playing a show, and it's like, but you that's the love and that's the passion, and it's really hard to break yourself out of that, especially if you're used to kind of regular society and things and links with whoever. It takes a special someone to be able to just dive straight in and go, let's go.
I mean, because we've just been like totally dedicated to this from the outset, haven't we? And like finding anybody else that's prepared to sort of be that involved in it has been hard.
Yeah.
I mean, we've
found Max
a couple of years ago, I guess we met. No,
yeah,
was it
yeah.
something like
about
that?
Yeah.
We've been kind of talking about it for ages and just kind of hanging out more and just getting to this point, really, isn't it?
It's great, man. Yeah.
You know, I mean, I've been working on sort of working on the recordings in here that Max, like for a couple of the bands of Dead Reds and Old Man that Max is in.
Well, it's nice having all these new tracks off the new album to really sit and work through and kind of create a bit of a new sound with it.
Yeah. I mean, we've been looking for somebody, but we haven't sort of found it.
So you were like actively sort of thinking that you wanted to add extra
it's always
sort of
been
colours to it?
Yeah. It's always been in our mind that we're like, you know, it's because the playing as a two-piece, there are certain limitations and certain freedoms with it.
Yeah.
I mean, you are bound sonically by what you can do. And for me, I have to keep like the bass going the whole time, so it's more like playing kind of finger picking guitar, really. But you can only go, there's a whole other side of my playing that I didn't really get to do that much, because you've kind of got to hold this thing down the whole time.
Yeah,
You know, we've been playing together like a hell of a lot more, haven't we? And we're
it's
let's
been
just
great, man.
Let's just do it. I mean,
trying to fill in those frequencies of a third member as well. I mean, it pans across between me and John having to share that role of the low end. Like, yeah. I play a lot more on my low floor toms and stuff when it's just the two of us, because it's also that tribal role of it. It kind of helps with the lack of that kind of bass guitar-ish element, or that other kind of rhythmic melodic element, you know.
Mm. So hence why we ended up with, like, you know, using bass and guitar amps, and then we're like, well, let's just do that again, so we've got like an even more massive sound out of it, and then we can chop and change between who's taking what part and where it sits. And it actually, instead of it just being like one instrument, you know, we've kind of got a variety of different places to go with it didn't have more. There's actually much more opportunity.
We're just getting stuck in now, really, aren't we?
Well, yeah, this is it, you know. We've been talking about it for ages, doing a little bit of prep, but now we're kind of getting to it and sounding pretty great.
So, so piano and backing singers on the next one?
Well, I mean, I'm not adverse to just going, I mean, I think Saltwater and this record have been the two closest together, and I might do something completely and utterly different next time. Mm. Obviously, guitar, bass, but...
Well, that's the thing, that is the vein through all of these, is fantastic guitar tones throughout. You want to tell us a couple of little goodies that you've been using on this record to get these great tones?
Well, lots of vintage valve amps. We've got these World War II US military Morse code senders that we had turned into valve amps, basically. Had the oscillator taken out, because it just produces like a kind of tone for the Morse code. So yeah, Eric brought those. Eric is also another special tool that we've been using. Mm. He's a secret goodie.
Yeah.
But yeah, he turned up with these amplifiers, so we kind of got those converted into valve amps, and been using those, and they're
awesome.
Completely unique, absolutely unusual pieces of kit. Various things. I mean, like, one of my guitars that I play a lot, I made myself at high school. It sounds like it does. It doesn't sound like anything else, and it just kind of produces this kind of tone. Obviously, a lot of the pedals we're using on kind of quite a lot of boutique valve pedals and various different bits and bobs. I mean, like, some of the speaker cabs I built myself as well, and I'm always chopping and changing around guitars, how they're set up, what kind of strings I've got on it, whether I'm using them as a slide guitar. How my pedal board works has been through a million different variations.
Do you set out with a specific sort of sound that you're looking for with these things? Because obviously when you can sort of get stuck in and build these things yourself, the end result can be quite variable. But do you know how you want it to sound, or is it just sort of hitting hope?
I mean, there's so much going on, especially like using... I mean, when we recorded, for example, I was using like five or six amplifiers at once, and, you know, the effect that one set of things has on the other. We were just constantly messing around, really, weren't we?
Yeah. I mean, there was a lot of the time when John was playing in here and I was in the control room, playing with the EQs of faders and stuff, and bringing each amp forward and back to kind of create that body that we needed, especially, again, because we were doing it as a two-piece, you know? It was a really good experience for me as well as a drummer to kind of understand more of these kind of tonalities and the way they work with each other, and pushing and pulling some can boost certain things and reduce others.
I mean, we did a lot more of the work. Like, you did certainly a lot of the edit, like quite a bit of editing and chopping around on it. We did a lot more of the kind of, we were a lot more hands-on in this. And because we had the studio, we could, you know, spend more time messing around than we normally would, and like experimenting with different ideas and all kind of different microphone setup. It's like a palette, really. It's like an artist's palette, isn't it? You know, you have a whole variety of different colours, and however you mix those things to kind of express what is. I mean, we had some ideas about what we wanted, then we just kind of developed them and went as far as we possibly could, really.
I mean, it's a fantastically produced record, and I think something that is really unique about it in comparison to some other modern records that are coming out is you managed to really keep a hold of that real analog sound that you guys get in here, you know. Was that something that was really important to you, to not have too much of a sort of sheen over the master?
Oh, definitely.
Yeah, I mean, we worked again. We did a lot of the recording here with Alex. We did some recording at Fish Factory Studios in London, which is also a absolutely fantastic analog studio. And we were working with Alex Beitzke again, who's done Saltwater, and he did Hungry Blues, so we've got a real idea of how we work with him and what we want. You know, it's been like a whole number of years been working with Alex now.
And Bradley Spence.
And Bradley Spence, yeah. So we kind of knew what we wanted and how we work together and what the vibe is over, you know, sort of long-term experience of working together, really. So, I mean, Alex did all the mixing on the album and, you know, he was just kind of sending us a mix and we were like, well, yeah, tweak that a little bit. Like, great, man, you know, yeah. He totally got it and knows what we, like, what we want and how we want to sound. And that working as a long-term progression with the same people, you know, you don't have to go through the same discussions again. You know, you've already got to a point of a level of understanding about what it is that you're trying to achieve.
Sure. You guys are just about to hit the road. It's been a little bit of a break from touring. Do you want to talk us through some of the highlights coming up on this tour? Where you're looking forward to playing?
I mean, we're kind of looking forward to the whole tour, really. We've had probably like five months off, which is the longest we've ever had off since we started. So I'm just really looking forward to getting back on the road, to be honest. I've been going a bit weird recently, I think. Not playing shows like but yeah, I'm looking forward. I mean, like, the release date for the album is the 12th of April, which we're releasing in the Old Courts in Wigan, my hometown, which is, you know, it's a big show.
The album title's The Divided Kingdom.
Yeah. And I see they've moved Brexit back to the 12th of April apparently now as well, like some kind of awful prophecy. So that's very kind of them.
Your birthday's on one of them, Toby, right?
The 13th.
It's the 13th, yeah. So it's Toby's birthday right
in
the middle of it.
That should be a good one.
Yeah, we're pretty much looking forward. We're playing in London at the Monarch as well. We haven't played there before, but it's a good rock and roll venue. We've got some nice venues on this tour.
Market Assembly Bristol, that should be a good one as well.
Yeah, Old Market Assembly in Bristol.
Patchwork Studios.
Yeah, it's a friend of ours' birthday again in a lovely analogue studio of theirs, which is always a real pleasure on a Napoleonic sort of a hilltop fort in Cornwall.
Looking forward to getting back on the road again.
Yeah, it's looking forward to being on the road.
Well, I can see all the 5-star reviews now, you know, and the sub headline of, you know, the soundtrack to Brexit.
Well, it's a weird thing, that, I mean, you know, that it was a weird thing, like, you know, sort of doing that. Does it put you in that? I don't think it puts you in that place at all forever. It's just you need to comment upon it, you know. It's weird. It is, like you say, it's a kind of weirdly concept album, but not a concept that we decided upon, one that's kind of been decided for us to comment upon, I guess.
Well, it's a great album, guys. Congratulations on it.
Thank you very much indeed. Cheers. Nice one. Been a pleasure.
Nice one.
Democracy.